Eh bien, bonjour à Jill Lounger et Beatles de ce monde. Comment allez-vous? How are you today? I hope that you are enjoying your holidays, que vous profitez bien des fêtes. Je vous avertis tout de suite, I'm warning you right now, that's going to be like a more quick video about the achievement of Agile Lounge. I'm going to be speaking French and English, not necessarily translating, mais on va faire le mieux pour que toute la grande communauté de Agile Lounger out there puisse... Donc, suivent, that follow me and that they spoke French and English. Alors, vous me reprocherez peut-être, mais ce n'est qu'une expérimentation empirique et on verra à faire éventuellement des vlogs dans une seule langue, français pour les francophones et anglais for the English speaker of the Agile Lounge. So, what I'd like to point is my top 13 of Agile Lounge, best moment of 2018. C'était la deuxième année. De ma compagnie et de ma marque Agile Lounge pour une nouvelle manière d'approcher l'enseignement, le coaching et le mentoring de l'agilité, du business agility as well as Scrum. Et puis, et vous verrez qu'en 2019, je vais prendre une toute autre tournure pour co-créer, en espérant avec des collaboratrices, des collaborateurs, encore beaucoup plus... d'amélioration continue dans la façon que nous pouvons aider les gens dans les organisations, et non pas les organisations, mais les gens qui sont dans les organisations, à être des agents de transformation et d'aller au-delà de leur espérance pour être plus heureux au travail. Et même en tant qu'entrepreneur, ça sera très important. Donc, beaucoup de choses s'en viennent en 2019. D'ailleurs, cette vidéo se vaudra peut-être une pseudo-revue de l'année de 2018 pour Agile Lounge. Mais elle sera teintée également de beaucoup de prospection hein, pour le cycle à venir qui sera la troisième année de la marque et où on va commencer. Je vais annoncer des choses très grosses comme la mort de l'Agile Coaching. Oui, la mort de l'Agile Coaching. Mais, without further ado, let's go up to... I will not share all the 13 right now because I'd like to be this video like just at the eve of the eve. Of 2019, reviewing 2018 would be mostly just to cheer you up, guys, in my nice living room, my penthouse. And out of the 13, I choose those 7 now to share with you. Puis vous pourrez suivre sur mon blog agilelounge.com, agilelounge.com on my blog, the rest of the list of my 13 best moments for agility, Scrum, and the development of the people. So, my number one, yes, I start with the first one, was meeting Mike Beadle in New York last March. And after 2 years of virtual training, and I virtual training with him, virtual meetings by Skype, Zoom, and so on, I finally assist one of his class and merge of the Business Agility Conference in New York City. That was March 10 to 12. So I was really pleased to finally meet him and have been certified. Actually, I was and I am the first Canadian ever, both language, Francais and English, to be certified by the Enterprise Scrum, which is a scaling agility framework. We do everything with Scrum. And I'm right now the business agility coach, the first one and on the list of their website. If you go to enterprisescrum.com and you go to the certified and trainee list, so you'll see me as the only and sole Canadian right now to have achieved this grâce au coaching de Mike. Et étonnamment, c'était donc mon number one thing to meet him after 2 years of virtual working, finally in person. And we had like a lot of plan to brought Enterprise Scrum into French and to expand this model, to find ourselves a wow moment, a wow organization and team to implement it even in Canada. Unfortunately, a tragic event happened on March 23rd, so that's paradoxal that this first top of my list of best moment of 2018 was also accompanied with the worst sadness thing that he passed away, unfortunately, into the streets of Chicago. That's 2 weeks after I met him and I made like a journey plan with him. Yes, that's it. So, Mike, thank you. Bless your family and your friends. And grâce à toi, I met a lot of astounding people that I continue the journey in 2018 and beyond. Number two of my best moments, c'était évidemment le gathering in making new bridges of professional contact into London for the Scrum gathering into London, the global Scrum gathering in London. That was a lot more interesting than the San Diego one that I assisted like 2 years ago. That was part of my journey for CEC. That stands for Certified Enterprise Coach, that I will continue this year. And to tell you the truth, that was an amazing moment in London, both professional and personal. But for the personal one, only the VIP will be able to catch the other video of my personal self into another lounge channel that I won't mention here, because here I'd like to keep it professional and expanding for now, because you will see in 2019, transparency might merge both lounges. But yeah, definitely number two, meeting those great people in London last October was amazing, learning more about user experience, customer-centric experience, and meet also John McFadden. Thumbs up to you. He's one of the great guys from Enterprise Scrum teaching and learning that we have across the sea there. And I hope that this upcoming year, Su Ryu, myself, and others from United States, Canada, and London will bridge more together for the expansion of this beautiful framework that is actually configurable in many ways. Number three of out of my top 13 of best moments of for Agile Lounge, c'était de rencontrer des nouveaux acteurs via le Centre international de leadership conscient. Oui, oui, oui. Vous avez bien entendu. You heard it right. It's the International Center for Consciousness, Conscious Leadership. Sorry. And so I met those people really like a couple of weeks ago in November, last November and December, and I found it really interesting. And I will start the year, I will kick off my year of 2019 this Friday, January the 4th, with une retraite urbaine avec Stéphane Leblanc, facilité par Stéphane Leblanc, donc président, CEO du Centre international du leadership conscient. Et pour moi, c'est exactement la façon de m'améliorer continuellement, donc d'aller plus loin dans les services professionnels qu'Agile Lounge et moi-même, on veut offrir dans une manière innovatrice et exclusive d'entraîner, de former, de coacher et de mentorer. Et c'est certain que... Et donc, c'est pour ça que je ne veux pas rester trop dans le technique du Scrum et de l'agilité. Je veux vraiment prendre une expansion viable pour accompagner les gens à devenir la better version of themselves. And becoming the better version of yourself, it's also including being happy and free, because your birthright is to be free on this experience and this planet. So definitely, that was my number three encounter for this year. And this is actually my present and moving onward. That will be very, very interesting, that everything that will come out with from this co-creation of conscious leadership and business agility are gonna like to create something out of it for sure. So stay tuned, because a lot of things are coming up. Number four was my consolidation of professional services in a diverse way. So that's the thing. As I said, I don't want to just teach Agile and just be a SME. So you know, when Robert Kiyosaki put the square of employees, SME, investor, and business. So for me, I'd like to mix all of those three. And of course, I'm not an employee anymore. I'm an entrepreneur, and I'd like to be an investor in the near future. And to become an investor, so I need to generate like more wealth and assets. And but truly, the number four here, it's the meaning of the fact that I finally, in less than 18 months, starting my trademark of Agile Lounge, not being the typical consultant that I was for 10 years back. Which means that I offer right now workshop, I offer individual and group coaching, so I have multiple sources of revenue. So now I can have checks with an S, not one check. So I'm not dependent on only one client or one type of thing. So I've reached out this year about 8 to 10 new clients. Big one, medium one, small one, who cares? The thing is, it's revenue streams. And 2019, we're going to see a lot more about this for myself and for my brand, Agile Lounge. So that was number four, the consolidation and expansion of my diversification of professional services, and finally, being free and independent. number five. It's a bridge of collaboration between the New York chapter of Enterprise Scrum and the meetup there. That was for the continuity of the great work of Mike Beadle, and I just created like also a meetup here, and so far we reach a lot of people. So that's gonna be very interesting because I'm going to be in New York, and I hope like Sue Ryu or Wei will come from New York to do some meetup here in Montreal. So that's gonna be very great in 2019. I can't wait for establishing this exchange of virtual and real contact between the two. Number six was the obtention of my CSP, Certified Scrum Professional. That's part of my journey of the CEC. That might be into a kind of, it's entering right now in a improvement cycle for me, improvement of my skills, upgrading my software to my brain and so on. Alors, on va voir. I'd like to cheer up Evelyn Tian to be my coach into that journey, to provide me with the different steps within Scrum Alliance. But in my aim goal of becoming free and independent with finding people to co-create and collaborate, I might change my way about this. So we'll see, because with the leadership, with the consciousness leadership, with other stuff that coming into a project in Fruitfield this year, I might realign this. But I put it on my number 6 out of 13 because I think it was a great achievement that I get 2 certifications only in 1 year. And so I made the time, so it's about like a couple of hours. So that's great. And I cheer out like Evelyn, because Evelyn, you're such an enabler for me to challenge me to upgrade myself, upgrade my skills, and so on. So thank you for that. And the number 7 was great achievement. It could have been like number 1, but you know, you have to decide, like when we teach product owner to rank and to prioritize their value list item. So that's the thing. So, but that number 7 could have definitely be on top of the thing, number 1 or 1.5, let's say, because it's the fact that I introduced only this year's 5 new teams using Scrum. And the amazing thing in that is 2 out of those 5 teams are not a development software company. One is Kitten Garden. In Quebec, we call the CPE, les Centres de la Petite Enfance. And another, it's Commerce de Détail / supplier of a couple of services for restoration. And so, yes, we implement Scrum into these things. So that's the thing. I am not a pure agilist that just work for software and IT. I go beyond that, above and beyond that. And so I was so happy and pleased to have my 816, 817, 818, 819, and 820. Yes, you hear it right. Since I'm doing Scrum back in 2002, and I have a great portfolio of it with picture of the red ribbon, this year, I reach in November 820 team that I introduced to Scrum, meaning that I train them, I provide them coaching, I help them like doing their release planning, and so on, implementing whatever they need from Scrum and configure it to their needs and context. So 820 team. So shout out for Tangerine Software, shout out for Ebus, shout out for Cole Bennett, shout out also for, they don't want to be mentioned, so I won't mention them. But great guys. I worked with them tonight, this year. And so, yeah, I'm so happy that I finally introduced almost like, so I'm reaching, I hope I'm gonna be able to make a video saying like my 1,000 team using Scrum, and that's gonna be something else than software development company. So that's a wrap up for now after 13 minutes of talking. So I hope you enjoy this. I hope, and please in the comment below, share your great top 5, top 10 moment for yourself as either an entrepreneur, a coach, a Scrum Master. What was your best achievement in 2018? C'était quoi vos meilleurs moments de 2018? Vous aussi, partagez-le dans les commentaires. Si vous aimez cette vidéo, by the way, Agile Lounge is not for revenue stream. I'm just doing it to be virtual, a virtual coach, a virtual enabler. But nevertheless, I'd like to have likes and subscribers to go out, for the message to go out. It's not for the money. C'est pas pour l'argent. C'est pas pour les arithmétiques de YouTube. Mais plus on va faire des likes, plus vous allez souscrire, plus vous allez partager ces vidéos-là qui vont être faites pas juste par moi. Il y aura d'autres coachs de Scrum Master qui feront des capsules, des vlogs. Et c'est pas pour faire de l'argent, on va pas le monétiser. Les règles sont trop stupides. On pourra peut-être demander des tips, à un moment donné, Tipeee ou Patreon, pour organiser des événements bénévoles, mais qui requièrent parfois de l'argent avec les meet-ups. Alors, je vais mettre des liens d'ailleurs dans la description si vous voulez vous inscrire au meet-up de Enterprise Scrum Montréal et surtout à Agile Scrum Beer Montréal. Et bientôt, qui sait, un troisième meet-up. Je vais d'abord demander à mes co-créateurs s'ils sont d'accord. Mais sérieusement, et le 31 janvier, on kick l'année. Il y a déjà 52 personnes qui ont répondu oui aux quatre origines dans Pointe-Saint-Charles, à côté du Nordelec, où il y a beaucoup de compagnies justement du numérique qui sont là. Donc 52 personnes se sont déjà inscrites pour le jeudi 31 janvier aux quatre origines. Ce sera notre premier beer, Scrum Beer Meetup. Ça, c'est inspiré de mes collègues à Dublin et ailleurs à travers le monde. Donc, enfin, Montréal aura son Scrum Beer. Alors, on vous attend. Ça me permettra de vous souhaiter la bonne année à ce moment-là, en personne, yeux dans les yeux, face à face. Et puis, parler d'agilité, de leadership conscient, de Scrum et de tout ce qui vous anime dans l'évolution de notre société, dans la transition, la transformation de notre société. Alors, au revoir, bonne fin d'année. Et puis, on se voit le 31 janvier aux quatre origines. Ciao!